It's Monday, July 22nd. The crew of Expedition 36 has launched a new week on orbit with a day filled with science and station maintenance. After kicking off the day with the morning daily planning conference, Commander Pavel VINOGRADOV started with some routine maintenance of supplies in the Russian segment of the station, and then he was joined by Flight Engineer Alexander MISURKIN to assist him with an evaluation of his cardiovascular function. This is done during a series of progressively more strenuous exercises that are done using the stationary bike. The information that's gathered from that study adds to the data for the scientists who are looking at ways the human body is affected by being in the weightless environment for an extended period of time, and ultimately, of course, to find ways to counteract those bad effects so future explorers can stay healthy while they're on longer exploration missions. VINOGRADOV finished off his regular treadmill exercise today, too, and after lunch, he focused on stowing items in the Progress vehicle before its undocking on Thursday, and then working on the Russian TV documentary about life on board the station. Alexander MISURKIN had his own daily exercise, as all crew members do each day, and spent part of his day on routine maintenance tasks for the Russian segment, and his afternoon working with Fyodor Yurchikhin on a Russian experiment that's looking into new ways to identify the locations where a pressurized space station may be leaking some of its pressurization. Flight Engineer Karen Nyberg's day has been devoted primarily to operations with the Robonaut. She set up the Robonaut 2, the R2 robot, in the Destiny laboratory, as well as the teleoperations equipment in Destiny, in order to monitor the operations with the commanding of tasks of the Robonaut from the ground. The Robonaut is a testbed for evolving robotic operations in space and demonstrating what a robot can do, as well as help the developers as they test the boundaries of what a robot might do in the future, including help a human crew with tasks inside the station and perhaps someday outside the station as well. Flight Engineer Luca Parmitano kicked off his week in the European Space Agency's Columbus Laboratory. He's reinstalling the microscope and the spectrophotometer in the biolab. They were removed for refurbishment back in 2011. The start of some biolab maintenance is in advance of an extended period of ground testing and commissioning to demonstrate that facility's ability to support some upcoming experiments on the effects of microgravity on a variety of biological organisms. Later in the day, Parmitano used the station's amateur radio to talk with students in Montevideo, Uruguay, and spent his afternoon getting in his daily exercise. Flight Engineer Chris Cassidy started off the day with his exercise and then moved to cleaning the smoke detectors in the Kibo laboratory module. He also spent some of his time helping Karen Nyberg with the Robonaut, and then moved on to setting up the fluids integration rack for the physical sciences investigation called Advanced Colloids Experiment Operations. It's the first in a series of microscopic imaging investigations of materials that contain colloidal particles. They're looking into the flow characteristics of these particles and the ordering effects the particles have on the materials in question. Looking ahead to Tuesday, there'll be more Robonaut operations and biolab maintenance, as well as packing Progress number 50 prior to its undocking. And for the Russian crew members, practice using the manual control system for Progress docking for the new Progress vehicle that is due to arrive at the station late on Saturday. Also coming up on Tuesday, for Luca Parmitano, a public affairs event to talk about what life is like on humankind's orbiting outpost.